say yes when I proposed.
David DeWitt!
Cheers, Frank. It's not been easy. As you all know, we didn't meet in the most romantic of saying. Screw to wed young offender, I think was one of the headlines. Yep, thank you, Daily Mail, for that. We never could have done or gone through any of this without the support and the love of Michelle's family. Sarah and Mike. Thank you for everything. We really couldn't have wished for a happier ending. I really do mean that. Michelle, I love you. And I'm going to make you as happy as you've made me. I'll try my best, at least.
To Michelle and Tony. Hip hip, hooray!
Hip hip, hooray!
Hip hip! I wonder what airline they're going to put me on. I always thought Ryanair. I haven't heard great things about Ryanair.
Please, God, let me British Airways, that's all I've
Can't hear the TV over this noise. Can anyone else hear the TV? My uncle said I could stay with him for a little while. I'll pay my own way, though. He's got a swimming pool and a jacuzzi. Well, he's getting a jacuzzi. At the moment, he's just got a pump, but that's a start, isn't it? All the houses in Turkey have got swimming pools, Tom. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to get myself a nice pair of designer trunks. My cousin works in Selfridges, she's going to put in a discount card. I'll get new clothes, I'll get a watch, a proper nice watch, Ralph Lauren slip-ons. I've started to save. You can never be too early to save, so.
Will you shut up, Frankie? No one fucking cares!
Get up.
What have I done?
Get up.
Ooh, someone getting towels off.
Do you want to go back to yourself?
Why are you picking on me? Or why are you telling Frankie to shut the fuck up?
This is exactly why you're getting into trouble.
He sat there running his mouth off about fucking Turkey.
Ignore him. Ignore.
What did he say your big plan was going to be when you got out of here?
What
did you say your plan was going to be?
We're all ears.
What the fuck's it got to do with you?
What was that? What did you say? Fuck on! He's moving in with his girlfriend. Oh, look, his ex-girlfriend in a little shitty council flat. Oh, the big dream.
Do you want to fucking snap on me? Me and Tanya are getting married, actually. Her cousin's giving me a job on his stall.
Ooh, a stall!
A speciality phone cover, design accessories. They're raking it in on the stall, Frank. You'd be fucking shocked.
Okay.
You just sit there and laugh, but I'm the one coming out to a solid job, not prancing about trying to get a little bit of bar work. A real wage, not just talk. I'm putting all my blueprints into action. I can work the stall daytime, get my side lamp going, sell a little bit of draw here and there, and before you know it, I'll have enough for my engagement ring. That's top of my list for you, truthfully. And not a cheap one before you say anything. I know exactly what I'm getting. White gold with a peridot stone. This is strange talk, gent. Bright green, good for everything, apparently. Peridot, the heart, the lungs. It cleanses the body if you're suffering, if you're scared, if you're angry, if you're jealous. That stone heals it. We must have been 14? I bumped off after registration with Alex and Paddy. We've been in his park for hours, lean, smoking and talking, and Paddy's cousin came with all these YSL t-shirts he just picked from sports world. And you appeared. I didn't know Alex had a sister. Immaculate. In your school uniform. I still feel it. That sudden jolt. I dream back to those first days. Through the smoke-filled haze of my memory. I still feel it. As if you were here now. Have we met? I said, I'm
Ian.
Oh, you are.
We're in the same year, but never crossed paths, because you were top of the class and I, in all the bottom sets. Ashamed. When Alex wouldn't go, fuck off, Tanya! Go home, yo! And with one last disapproving look, you left. It was then I knew, with whatever it took, I had to have you. I'd use every last trick in the book. Alex would be at football on Wednesday night, so I waited. For what some lucky chance might bring. The door opened, I followed a kid into your block of flats. Turned up at your door my new YSL and chocolate liqueurs nicked from my mum's cupboard. Unsure at first, and then you smiled. And there on your balcony, we stood for a while, scoffing old chocolates, watching the light behind the roofline's fade. You know, you were the most perfect person I'd ever met. And one day, I'd marry you, Tanya. I already know which window yet.
Margaret!
Eh?
Is Margaret there?
God, I've seen her for years.
Oh, look, right there. Look, her, behind the reporter. Look, in the red crow. With the crutches.
And we return to Big Ben, where we join Big Brother runner-up Lisa for the countdown to...
Margaret, I just remember crying and crying when I had to go. I've been here about a month and they won't let me stay on one more night. Not even for my birthday. I was going to be 11. And social came and brought a car to collect me. They wouldn't even let me stay. Margaret was asking if there was any way at all, just until tomorrow. I was standing at the top of the stairs, bawling my eyes out. And there was nothing anyone could do. They just made up their mind to pack me off, and Margaret went into the kitchen, and she pulled out this cake she'd made the night before. I didn't even know she'd done it. But Jenny knew. Jenny was my little sister, not my real sister, but another kid Margaret was looking after. It was a sponge cake, coconut cream and raspberry jam. She grew raspberries in the garden, you see. She only had a little garden, and we were always out there, the three of us, with these little plastic gardening tools she got for the children she looked after. And I can just see Margaret staying up in the night just making this cake. And the social worker's at the door. And there's nothing anyone can do.
Five.
So Margaret cut a slice of meat and wrapped it in the cling film, and I remember going down the motorway in the back of this car, holding this squeegee bit of cake in my hand, and it was getting warm. Saying over and over, 14 Aradine Road, Middlesex. 14 Aradine Road, Middlesex.
Three.
Because I knew I was never going to see either of them again.
Two.
But maybe I could write.
One.
And I have been. Without fail, ever since.
Happy New Year.
Get a job. You're 20 years old and you're living like a star.
Was early, isn't it, to be back at work? No. Christmas and New Year goes in the blink of an eye and then you're back behind your desk in hell. Still, I suppose it's all right for you. You're waiting, aren't you, Michael?
Tony. You just call me Michael. My name's Tony. Two bricklaying, plastering, I've got basic maths. I should be able to get onto a college course. I want to do construction.
You need GCSEs to do an intermediate course at college, Tony, even something like bricklaying.
I'm not doing bricklaying, I want to do construction.
Even construction needs all GCSEs, unless of course you will spend a couple of years in the leaky
tenant
or a city.
I will, I'll do it.
Good. You go for it. Okay, so. You'll have a probation officer who'll report to you straight after your release, and once a week from then on. The hostel staff will be keeping the probation...
Wait, a hostel? What do you mean hostel?
Well, we can talk about that
then. No, we can't. Look, I can't go back there. You know what some of these places are like? It's just filthy. There are people coming in and out at all hours, smoking crack in the corridor. The last hostel I was in, I lived next door to a bloke with a samurai sword in his room. I could hear him stomping about, smashing stuff open with his sword.
So where else are you going to live?
My mum, my foster mum, well, she only lives down the road in Greenford. I still write to her. She'd let me stay for a bit.
But you just said you haven't been well.
Did I?
Just then. We can talk about this next week, okay?
Yeah.
See you then.
Oh, but...
Oh, you know this. When's Poe's meant to start again after New Year?
Well, I sent the letter the other night, so it's outgoing.
But it's like the 4th of January now, and you would have thought it'd been here by now.
Post? Ian!
What? No word yet about your bit of bollock?
Tanya! I'm surprised you can write with her big fucking massive chin pans. Some of us are too busy for girlfriends!
When you've got a girlfriend.
Exactly! Because I'm far too busy, aren't I? I'm building the empire, mate.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You know, what? With the club nights, the press, the marketing. My schedule's packed. I've got to keep on with publicity, you know, social media. And
fuck off, Frankie!
I'm going to be the big selling point in the club, obviously.
You said you was working in a bar.
No. Well, actually, yeah, it's like, it's a bar slash club. What?
It's your shop.
Oh. I'm going to have to pull out the funky one-liners, you know. Wait a minute.
There it is.
No, actually, fuck off, like, I need a woman. Miss? What does this feel like?
I'm not touching you, Frankie. Get on with your game.
It's boyfriend material.
To get it?
Oi! You ain't even playing!
I am.
Thanks for the time that you've
The memories are all in my mind, and now that we've come to the end of our rainbow, there's something I must say out loud.
Choking your own blood, I swear to God, don't you dare forget who I am!
Now listen,
Listen. No, no, speak! I feel sick, do you know that? Sick that I was ever with such a cheap, nasty little slut. The minute I get out, I'll come straight round to your mum's house and I'll hold her down and beat her till she tells me where you are. And then I'll come round your house and cut that filthy little thing out of you and watch you bleed to... No! No! You're not fit to speak to me, Tanya! Don't even try and be! I swear to God, I swear I'll come round your house! I'll get people to come round your house, Tanya! Be careful! Watch your back, you bitch!
Be strong and courageous. We love every one of us, even through our faults. Rejected, broken, it is the Lord, your God, who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you.
What's up to you, sleep?
I don't know,
too much thinking.
Did you get your letter?
What?
What about your job?
What's it got to do with you?
Well, I'm just asking if the post works. I'm waiting on news myself.
Oh.
Well, there's just been nothing from Margaret, but all her needs.
I didn't get a letter. I just got a phone call.
I've got to get a reference to some silly woman. I mean, she doesn't even own the bar. She owns half of it. And I'm like, what more of a reference do you need? I'm his nephew. Mum's seeing what she could do. But I'll get a reference. I'll get two, in fact. I'll get one off Nick, first and foremost. You know, the one who gave me the job, this job, right? And I'll get one off the chaplain. You know, she won't let me down. She knows the whole story. Mark my words, nothing's going to get in the way of this. This job is happening. And she'll like me when she meets the promotion. Everyone likes me.
We're not even meant to be doing this on our own. Where's Michael?
Oh, he's gone. He got transferred.
Oh?
Ah, oh, you didn't hear. He got a guard sacked. Y'all got caught and everything.
Why?
He was having it off with her.
Are you serious?
Yeah! She got a sack. Phil says there's going to be some massive review. Guards are going to be restrained and spot checked of inappropriate looks and everything. Stops us from getting exploited, I say.
I could wait though, but if you liked us so
wait,
much.
Wait, what? Minute he's out here, that's it. Game over.
Tony, message for you.
Enfield? What the fuck's she doing in Enfield?
Someone's done well for themselves.
What? Who's pulled up in the driveway? What do you mean you didn't get a look? Get a fucking good look. Who is it? Just take a second to look.
Fine.
Just get out of there. Time it carefully. Come back tomorrow.
Did we get the thing about the hostel sorted? Because I think I can stay at Margaret's until...
Oh, she died 4 years ago.
No, she didn't, because I just saw her on New Year's Eve, and she was behind the report.
Anise got your letters, and she wanted to thank you. She knows how much Margaret meant to you. And actually, she wanted you to go along to the memorial they're having. I've got the details here. It'll be... Careers Office Agent speaking. I'm sorry, I've got someone with me at the moment. Oh, John, just the man. I wanted to speak to you, actually. How's your wife's ankle? Oh, you do have to keep it up, yes.
Sorry, when's the memorial?
Yeah, I did call yesterday afternoon. Why did I call? Oh, three things.
I need to get out of here. Look, can you just give me the details, please?
One moment, just one. Sorry, John, I've got someone with me at the moment. It's here. John, hi. Yes, I wrote a list actually because I knew I'd forget. Number one, my desk drawer keeps ticking. Number two, the towel dispenser in the ladies' loo has given up the ghost completely. And three, who do I speak to about pastry crumbs in the keyboard? Yes, I got the joke.
I'll go for you.
Yeah, but on the other hand, should I just shake it out over the beard?
Michelle Watson, flat 1, Menzies Court, Aversham Road, W72EQ. Dear Michelle, let me start off by saying that I'm sorry to write you like this, and I shouldn't be doing this at all. I know that. But I really feel as if I'm losing it. And I think you might be the only one I can tell. I've been keeping my head down and working and doing the best I can, but no matter how hard I try, nothing seems to be going right for me. I've just been told that my mum's passed away. I'm still hoping that this might be wrong. I'll find out the truth when I'm out next week. So, I'm just holding on to that for now. I can't describe the pain that I'm in. Sometimes I think it might be better if I was just dead. I could really do with a friend right now. I have nothing in my life to look forward to. Nothing happy. Nothing beautiful. Except you. And it always has been. Right from the first day. And I know you won't remember, but you was walking towards me just there. It happened in this corridor, and you said, good morning. And I acknowledged it, because, I don't know, but, and that night you came up to me in association and asked me how I was getting on. And you took me over to Frankie, who was round with Ian at the pool table, and then the next day, you specifically came to Marcel and gave me an education pack and told me all about the jobs in here. And you've always been like that. You've always stepped in. You're the only one that's ever seemed to think of me at all. You're my soul, soul saving, Michelle. And more than ever now, I need you. If you could just give me just that bit of hope, please, please.
She was violently assaulted this afternoon by a family friend. I'm sorry.
Can I call her?
She's in surgery.
What? She gonna pull through?
I don't know. Do you want to go and see a counsellor? Ring the bell for change of mind. I'm sorry again.
But she was just, it was games with her. I mean, why let her go on for so long? Why let me believe we had any kind of chance? Did she think she was doing me a favour? Just look, look.
Dearest Ian, how are you? I'm sorry you haven't been in touch this week, but I've had so much on that college. And this one. I've been thinking about you, although I've not been able to write as much as I'd want. I hope you're looking after yourself. I'm not making it up.
It was real. Oh, it's all here. It's all real. She just needed to wait just a few more months. If she could have just waited, I would have never have done it. Ask anyone, ask her. She knows how much I love her. She knows, she knows.
Well, basically, I'm coming out of prison in 2 days' time. And
Right, wow.
Yeah, I've got my reference and I've got my savings together to pay for my flights and all of that.
Flights?
So, yeah, I'm working at my uncle's bar in Turkey.
Turkey?
Yeah.
After probation, of course.
What?
Probation period. You're on probation for,
let me
just get the right up.
I didn't, what? Sorry.
I've left my glasses at home, which is typical.
Look, I don't know what you mean by probation.
How do I say it? Basically, the length of the time after your release that you're not allowed to leave the country.
What? No, 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 no!
Can you just calm yourself?
Yeah, I'm calm. I'm calm. Listen. Everything's been sorted. I've got my job, I've got savings, I've got a reference.
Two and a half years. Probation period. You won't be going anywhere for 2.5 years.
Did you know?
No more.
I can't fly! When I'm on probation, I can't fly! Did you know this?
You knew?
Why didn't you say anything?
I wasn't sure what the rules were.
And who else knew? Did it? I'm fucking laughing at somebody who's taking one on me. There's fucking Frankie. That's enough all the time. Bet you're all pissing yourselves, weren't you? I mean, of all people, Tony, you could have told me the truth. What? You could have never taken me to one side and just...
Yeah, and what good would that have done?
What good would it have done? I know there's no such thing as friends in here, Tony, but you don't owe me anything. But you know it would have been a decent thing to do.
But your uncle in wait, won't he?
Yeah. For 2.5 fucking years, I don't think so.
You'll find something, Frank, you always do.
It wasn't about a job, Tone. I could have been someone else. This. All of this. It would like it never happened. But it has. It's never going to be over.
Leave that, please. This is... How did you get my address? No!
Miss, I'm really sorry. Please don't tell anyone. I was never going to send it.
Come with me. You need to see the wing manager.
But I'm begging
you,
please.
Come with me.
Never went to church. Just get on with work. And sometimes things will work. But it's hit me since you left us. It's so hard at night to search.
Oh God. You're giving me everything I deserve. I mean, what was I thinking? Frankie. Someone you're gonna be reckoning with. Gonna put the world to rights. Yeah, look how that went. What you got next for me? Hmm? What you got waiting round the corner? Now, I don't feel I can take any more. I don't feel I can spend any more lonely nights searching pamphlets and prayer book for any tiny little bit of hope. The game's up, and I can accept it. How long you been there?
I've just come in. Never been in a chapel before. Can I talk to you for a second, Frank?
Sleep. thinking over the plans and lists and everything to do, and I just try anything to keep him back. But he's watching. He's always watching. He will never leave me. And if I'm honest, I really feel it's what I deserve. I've been speaking to God a lot, and I think he's saying exactly the same thing. I'll be ending this by saying thank you for everything you tried to do with Uncle Ernest's job. I really loved him, but it wasn't anything. It wasn't your fault how you turned out, Mum. It doesn't matter anyway. I love you, Mum, and it breaks my heart to think. To think what we've done to you. Do me a favour, please, and forget this ever happened. Just forget I was ever born. I'm going to go somewhere where I can't keep doing any more harm. I love you always. Your baby boy, Frankie.
Tony, I'm Margaret's son. Yeah, Foster's son.
I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away. And I saw the holy city, and I heard a great voice out of the heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them. God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying.
Yeah.
Neither shall there be any more pain,
yeah.
For the former things are passed away.
My mum's coming in. I'm not allowed to be with my son. You have a mirror and a bottle.
Construction level one.
Oh wow, thank you.
I'm buzzing, you know. I mean, I've not had a day off since I got out, yet every day's been brimming over. And I'm doing a placement next month for Shutters, and I was really lucky to get it. You know, they're the biggest office construction company in Europe, and I don't know if you've ever heard of them, but I'm just keeping my fingers crossed that will kind of keep me on until the end of it. There's just ain't enough hours in a day. Can't concentrate. I'm up every morning, really early.
Where are you living now?
Oh, my foster mum's, you know, just down the road actually. We're just doing the garden. I'm just on my way back now. Replanting the berries, you know, washing the headstone. Oh, and I'm engaged.
Oh.
Yeah. We're keeping it quiet for a bit. You know, her parents don't know yet, so, you know, just.
Well.
You know, however grown up it all is, you know, I just feel like a little child around her. You know, she really, really saved me. She's just. You know, it's alright. I won't bore you. Margaret's waiting in the garden for me. I've got all these planting sticks, you know? You know what? Tell her, will you? Tell careers and the wing managers, you know, how well it's going for me. I'd like them to be proud of everything I've achieved. Because I missed up the first dance, okay? So put your hands on my shoulder. Yeah.
Interview commencing at 12:38 a.m. Oh. Take a seat, please, Mr. Marshall. Right, tell us exactly what happened. You went to the cab office with your friend, got a taxi, what next?
Oh, I sat in the front passenger seat. My mate was behind the driver. He took us into the housing estate and pulled out a knife. And I said if he didn't give us his takings, I'd stab him. So my mate had a cord in his pocket and he took it out and wrapped it around the driver's neck. He choked him for a bit till he gave us the money out of his pocket. Then he gave us the keys. We kicked him out of the car and just stabbed him in the chest a couple of times.
You alright, Tom? How's it going?
Yeah, not too bad. Frankie? Frank!
He's on all these painters and stuff for his head.
Bye.
You alright though, Tom? It's good to see you.
Oh God.
Yes, it's good to be
free.
Back.
Two.
I was just thinking of you.
Happy New Year.